Hi, I am Cristi with cristiferart Studio, and we are located in Puerto Vallarta, Mexico. Cristiferart Studio was founded by Fernando Gonzalez and myself, Cristiana Mar, and we are both painters with more than 30 years of painting experience and teaching since 1989. This moment, we are teaching mostly online. Probably we will get back to teaching in person in 2021. I started as painting from life, painting flowers, painting trees, painting the objects in the house around me when I was 5, 6, 7 and older. I started with drawings, drawing in pencil, everything I saw around me. And then when I started buying paints, whichever paints I knew how to buy because nobody guided me, were oils. So here you have a 7-year-old going to the store buying oils, and I had no idea what the heck I was doing. As I went to school, I started painting in watercolor. So over the years, I got a training through school, through college. I graduated from the School of Visual Arts in New York City and went to Art Students League, wonderful place in New York City also. So when I paint in studio, I like to look at the photo that helps me transpose myself back to the place where I was when I taken the photo, and to put myself back in that place in all ways with all my senses. So, for example, this is a photo I've taken in San Miguel de Allende. It's a window, as you can see. And what got my attention here, probably at the moment, are these blue shutters and the flowers. So if I want to paint something like this, I'm not gonna copy this photo. This photo has a lot of limitations, but I'm gonna improve it. And the first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna make it much brighter. These flowers here, I'm sure that they were much, much brighter. I like the lights. I like the two lights, right and left. So I'm gonna definitely incorporate these, the two lights. And the yawnings that are over the door and the window. Another photo I've taken in San Miguel is this window. And I think what is striking about it is the fact that it's so close to the sidewalk. And the fact that San Miguel de Allende and Guanajuato in general, it's a hilly town. So this is very characteristic of that. You can see the sidewalk as being in an angle. This is, again, a photo that I will never copy. It doesn't have a good composition. Composition is really important to me, where you place things. For example, what's not working for me in this composition, it's this column that I've cut here, so I don't see what's going on here. So it creates a lot of tension when you have an element that is so proeminent and is just, it's not that it's bleeding out of the page, it's that you can see that I cut it right there where it was ending. Now, my photos are not the very best photos you're gonna find, because I take them with my phone. I've taken them with a camera I bought 20 years ago in Target. And I like to work with photos that are not perfect, because it challenges me. It challenges me to remember where I was when I've taken this photo. Also, it's challenging me to improve it. How can I, if I have a perfect photo, why do I need to paint it? I mean, that's my approach. This is another photo from San Miguel de Allende, and again, very characteristic. The window here is sitting almost on the sidewalk. It has the water drainage. all this stained wall and the old wood. So I'm gonna keep all these characteristics in my painting. I'm gonna work on this texture, and I'm gonna decide if I want to have it straight front or if I want to have it in an angle, like going down the street. And I'm gonna create more negative space, more ambience here around this window that needs some breathing space and definition. If I'm gonna crop this window, then I need to do it somewhere here, so I don't have all this confusing line that is just creeping out the page. Another photo I have that I've taken in San Miguel is this one. And when I've taken this photo, the bougainvillea was just the jacaranda trees that are all purple, and the bougainvillea over here was just spectacular. But the photo, it's flattening everything, it's not capturing the vibrance of the colors and the feeling of the color. I have done a little sketch while I was there. So the sketch, it's gonna help me a little to remind myself how it felt to be there. Sometimes I make little notes and I write pink flowers, purple trees, and so forth, to because it's more than the drawing, is the colors that I cannot always capture in the photo. A photo I've taken around Christmas. Again, for some reason it's pretty blurred. I don't know what happened, but I think I can do a pretty good painting out of this. What I like, what I look in, when I look at the photo, I look at, do I have all the information that I need? And I have a lot of information here. So besides the structure of the window and the structure of the door, the characteristic details of the window here, these skirts that the Central Mexico, Guanajuato windows have, these little skirts. I have the texture of the wall, that again, very characteristic. I have this column that is separating this building of this building. And here I can see the color of the building next door and the colors that are here down here. So it's just a peek, right? It's just peeking a little bit. But this is gonna help me to enhance and to create a whole other building next to it. So it's because I have enough information. Also, I have, it shows me the angle of the street. So I can always continue the angle of the street. I can extend it. And I can create a square painting, or I can create a horizontal painting with this. And I haven't painted this particular from this photo, but I'm looking forward to use it in the near future. Lots of the paintings that I've done, they're sold. Many of the doors that I've done, street scene, views, and the simpler one I use with students. This is not a simpler one, but it's what I do. I put them in cellophane envelope to protect them from paint when I'm gonna use them for painting with students. Well, these particular doors I really love. I'm looking forward to paint them. And those doors are in Guanajuato. Guanajuato, the capital. Guanajuato is the capital of the state of Guanajuato. And they're very characteristic. And you can see, for example, if I look at these two together, I can see they are both from the same state, but they are from different cities. Now, look at the size of the frame of the door in this one. Narrower, not so much decoration. This one heavier, with the yawning above and the extensions on the bottom. Both of them are how do you say, they're protected, they're magical cities, and they are kept as much as possible in the colors and in the way that they were maybe 100, 200, 300 years ago. I have several photos that I've taken. For example, this photo I've taken from the terrace of our house in San Miguel de Allende. I love this photo and I'm looking forward to paint it. Here behind me, I have a canvas board that I'm going to be painting on. And here I have a painting that I started probably a year ago as a demonstration. Okay, about our workshops, we offer workshops of one session, two sessions, five sessions. At this moment, all the workshops are online and none in person. Probably in 2012, we will start offering workshops here in Puerto Vallarta. And if you would like more information about us or information on the workshops, please send me an email or check our website. Also, I'm going to post another video that is a slideshow of doors of Mexico that are the subjects of one of our workshops. And pretty much all these doors are doors that started as demonstrations in classes. Thank you very much for finding this video, and wish you well. I wish you to be healthy and save yourself and your family. Bye-bye.